NCAA basketball finals at Louisville, California against West Virginia in a down-to-the-wire thriller. The Golden Bears have overcome an early West Virginia lead and gone on to dominate the game into the final 10 minutes with a heads-up pressing game. California runs its lead to a 13-point margin with only minutes left to play. Golden Bears, lowest rated of the four final contenders, seem to have the game sewed up as the clock ticks out. Then the Mountaineers surge back. Jerry West shoots. Darrall Imhoff knocks it out. Goaltending is called. Basket counts. California leading by only 1 point. Nearly a minute left to play. Bears are fighting desperately. Imhoff gets underneath. Misses. But taps in the rebound. California leads by three. Mountaineers are still red hot. Fancy West Virginia play again cuts the California lead to 1 point. But it's enough. The Golden Bears win 71-70. Pacific Coast's first NCAA crown in 17 years. Four horses and perfect weather. A chilly gray mist at Aintree for the Grand National. 100,000 fans cheer the start of the 4-mile, 856-yard steeplechase with 30 jumps, the world's toughest horse racing course and one of the great turf classics. Thundering hoofs at a stirring spectacle. Every jump takes its toll. Odds don't mean a thing. By the end of the first circuit, 16 horses are out of the race. But the excitement rises steadily. It's a supreme test of mounts and men. Each year, the Grand National takes a heavy toll. This year, one horse was killed, a dozen jockeys injured, one seriously. Lindbergh and Oxo running abreast lead the survivors, 4-0. They're running carefully now. They're over Valentine's Brook. The last jump, and on the final 484-yard stretch, Oxo's ahead. Lindbergh challenging gamely, but Oxo shows a terrific turn of speed at the crucial moment to win going away. A length and a half triumph for the 8-year-old, an 8-1 shot, as the British put it, Bravo, Oxo.